In this video, we are going to discuss translational mechanical systems clearly. In the last class, we introduced about mechanical systems. We are having translational as well as rotational mechanical system. In this class, we are going to introduce translational mechanical system and we are going to discuss clearly about this translational mechanical system. So, first of all, translational mechanical system is nothing but which is a mechanical system moves along a straight line. Here we are having three basic elements like mass. So here the basic elements in translational mechanical system is mass dash spot dash pot and spring. These three are the basic elements in translational mechanical system. So here when we apply any force on these three elements, any one of these three elements, we are having an opposing force by mass, dashpot or spring. By mass or dashpot means friction, or spring means elasticity. The opposing force due to mass, that means acceleration, or elasticity or friction. Dashpot means we are having friction for the dashpot. Due to that friction, we are having opposing force. For spring, we are having elasticity. When we apply force on that spring, due to the elasticity of the spring, we are having opposing force. So, like that, here also when we apply any force on a body or a mass, which stores kinetic energy, we are having some opposing force which is called as AFM. So here we will examine one by one what about the force on mass, what about the force on dash spot, what is the force on spring. We will discuss one by one. For example, if you are dealing with mass, just forget about dash spot and spring. So just consider a mass. I am considering a mass M. So, this is fixed one side. So, this is the reference. This is mass M in kg. Here, I am applying a force F here. The displacement is also towards like this. Force and displacement are in the same direction. So, when we apply any force on this mass, we will get opposed by another force produced by this mass. That force is called as EFM. Always the opposing force and applied force are in opposite direction. Here, whatever the force, whatever the opposing force is there, that is related to acceleration of the body. That means, whatever the opposing force is there, that opposing force is proportional to acceleration of the body. So, here I am writing Fm is equal to Ma, where M is the mass of the body and A is the acceleration of the body. The same thing I am writing it as M into d square x by dt square, where acceleration we can write in terms of displacement x as d square x by dt square. According to Newton's law, whatever the force we applied on the body, so that is equal to opposing force. So here we can write F is equal to Fm is equal to m into d square x by dt square. This is the force when we apply on a mass M. Similarly, when we apply any force on a dash spot, what we will get? So, we'll see second concept, force on dashpot. Dashpot. Dashpot means it will be like this. So, here we are having a reference this side, and here from this side I am applying some force to this. So, here we are having some friction for this dashpot, where B is the friction coefficient, and here the displacement of this piston is like this in this direction. if you apply any force on this dashpot, so according to the friction of this dashpot, because of the friction of this dashpot, we will get some opposing force. That opposing force we will indicate with FB. Always that opposing force we will indicate with FB, and that is proportional to velocity. So here this is proportional to velocity. So here I am writing like this, FB is equivalent to B into V, where B is the friction constant. So we know that FB is equivalent to B into, in place of velocity, if you want to write in terms of displacement, you can write it as dx by dt. So according to Newton's law, you can say F is equivalent to, FB is equivalent to B into dx by dt. According to Newton's second law, all the forces on a body, if you are added, that will be is equivalent to 0, according to Newton's law. So according to same Newton's law, so the force applied is equivalent to force opposed. So F is equivalent to, FB is equivalent to B into dx by dt, where F is the applied force, FB is the force, opposing force due to friction of the dashpot. For example, here dashpot is fixed to a reference value. For example, two sides of this dashpot are free, then that means two sides are free. So it is like this, for example. So here you are having some x2 displacement, here you are having some x1 displacement. This is not fixed. If second side is not fixed, if you are not having any reference, then you will write like this, FB is proportional to, so V means dx by dt, so d by dt of x1 minus x2, we will write like this. When one side is fixed, the equation of force will be like this. When one side is not fixed, when no side of, when any side of this dashpot is not fixed, then the equation will be like this. So again, FB is equivalent, F is equivalent to, FB is equivalent to B into d by dt of x1 minus x2. This will be the force equation of dashpot whenever two sides are not fixed. When one side is fixed to a reference, then the equation will be like this. When two sides are free, then the equation will be like this. Coming to spring, we are having third element of the translational mechanical system as spring. So spring will be like this. So here spring is always having elasticity. So depending upon elasticity, if we applied any force on that spring, so we will get some opposing force due to that elasticity of spring, because spring stores potential energy. So because of that potential energy, because of that elasticity, we will get some opposing force. That opposing force, I am treating it as Fk, and is proportional to, Fk is proportional to displacement. Fk is always proportional to displacement, that means x. So here whenever spring is fixed to a reference level, so this is when, if spring is fixed to a reference level and you are applying a force and the displacement is in the same direction. So here Fk is equivalent to kx. So Fk is equivalent to, kx is equivalent to F, the force when one side is fixed to a reference is equivalent to kx for spring. For example, two sides are free for a spring. So that means, so if the spring you are applying is like this, x1 and x2, this side x1 and this side x2, and here you are applying force now. So no one of the end is fixed to a reference. then what will happens? Fk is proportional to x1 minus x2. So that implies F is equivalent to Fk is equivalent to k into x1 minus x2 will be the force on spring when two ends are free. What is the force of spring in translational mechanical system when two ends are free? The answer is k into x1 minus x2. What is the force on spring for a translational mechanical system when one end is fixed to a reference? So force is equivalent to kx. What is the force on a mass? What is the force on a mass when reference is fixed? So here this is the force on mass, m into d square x by dt square. Coming to dash spot or damper. So what is the force on dash spot whenever one end is fixed? So Fb is equivalent to Bv or B into dx by dt will be the force on dash spot. And coming to another equation of force for dash spot when two ends are free. So Fb is equivalent to F equivalent to B into d by dt of x1 minus x2, where M is the mass, B is the friction coefficient, K will be the elasticity constant of the translational mechanical system. This is about translational mechanical system. Translational mechanical system is nothing but this is a mechanical system which moves along a straight line. Here we will get, we are having basically three basic elements. We must have three basic elements in the translational mechanical system, that is mass, spring and dashpot. So when we apply any force on these three elements or translational mechanical system, we are getting opposing force by this mass or spring or dashpot. So whatever that opposing force by the three elements is there, that we derived now. So we derived all the three forces that we will get when we apply force on that translational mechanical system. These are the forces we are having in translational mechanical system according to the elements of translational mechanical system. So based on this, we will see some problems from the next class.